Cook hits unbeaten 50 after Somerset skittled. Somerset were swept aside with ease by Hampshire in their season opener at the Aegeus Bowl, so they returned to the Cooper Associates County Ground, hoping to bounce back. In their way, an Essex side who'd piled on the runs against Kent last time out, albeit in a draw. Having won the toss, the visitors took to the field, and their hosts were under pressure pretty quickly. Ben Green, the first man to go, caught behind for 15 off the bowling of Stacchetti. It wasn't long before they were two down. Renshaw's faint inside edge enough to drag Cook's delivery onto his stumps. Hildreth then followed with a score on 32, another for Stacchetti, pouched by Wheater for 5. Even the captain Tom Abel could do little to stem the tide, another for Cook, the ball looped off Abel's pads by way of an inside edge into the hands of Dan Lawrence. Cook was having some day, Goldsworthy unable to get off the mark, a second in the over for the bowler. The experienced Stephen Davis succeeded where his colleagues had failed. He stayed with Tom Lamonby, who had the 50 up with just his second boundary of the innings. The score was 70 for 5 when they headed in for lunch. Essex already on top, Somerset with some thinking to do. The keeper's resistance proved to be short-lived though, out soon after the resumption, taken high by Wheater off the bowling of Snater. The score was 79 for 7 when Harmer struck for his first. Gregory's edge found, the all-rounder gone for just 4. Lamonby was ploughing a lone furrow and running out of partners, but coped well. He was starting to think about a 50. Overton helped Somerset avoid being skittled for under 100. His 2 through the offside enough to see 3 figures on the board, but that proved to be the extent of his contribution, bowled by Stacchetti, who now had 3 to his name. Lamonby finally succumbed, 2 runs shy of his 50, and attempted reverse his downfall, Harmer and Cook combining again. And they did it one more time, this time to end the innings. Siddle out, caught by Cook. Wheater's blushes spared by the former England captain. Somerset had slumped to 109 all out and had lasted just a session and a half under the concerted pressure of Essex's attack. Lamonby had resisted the longest, his 48 the top score, Green's 15 a distant second. 3 bowlers had picked up 3 wickets each, but with 9 maidens from his 15 overs, Cook had been the most impressive. And where Somerset's openers had been all at sea, Brown and Cook found calm waters to get the Essex innings up and running. And it was plain sailing for the openers, all the way through to tea. 40 on the board without much to concern them, they were now trailing by just 69. The early stages of the evening session were just as kind to Essex. Cook and Brown waltzing past 50 runs together, the edge off Overton tantalisingly out of reach of the Somerset slip cordon, but effective nonetheless. Overton struck back, Brown well taken by Abel to depart for 25, perhaps a glimmer of hope for Somerset. Essex, though, were unmoved. Cook collected and organised, now joined by his captain, and parity was possible before the close of play. Cook found his way to 50, scored in characteristically patient style. The score was now almost on level terms with Somerset. They were 6 runs shy of that first innings total when Wesley had to go. Another for Overton. The captain strangled down the leg side. In as night watchman was Cook the younger, who stayed with his exalted colleague as they easily found their way to level pegging before the end of the day. And that's where they'd finish. Essex, 109 for 2. Cook, 59 not out, and a fine day for the visitors sealed. Somerset, though, will be determined to find something to cling on to if they're to play their way back into this match. Morning wickets are a must, but with Cook in this kind of form, that's easier said than done. Alarm bells rang at the Cooper Associates County Ground as the home side's batting went up in smoke. They'd managed just 109 runs in their first innings, a figure matched by Essex for the loss of only 2 wickets. They'd resume on day 2 on level terms, and with Sir Alistair Cook unbeaten on 59. But he lost just 1 ball, out to the first delivery of the day, caught by Hildreth off the bowling of Siddle, just what Somerset were looking for. Sam Cook's stint as night watchman was then put to bed by Craig Overton, arms shouldered, stumps rattled, Essex now 4 down. They were getting a little taste of what they dished out to Somerset on day 1, Lawrence getting a little bogged down and trapped in front by Siddle. The wickets kept tumbling, Critchley the next to go cheaply, caught by Renshaw off the bowling of Overton for just 7. A reprieve for Rossington, the catch tantalisingly out of reach of the slip cordon, the hosts now with their tails up. It was brief though, he fell in the next over, Overton with his 5th of the innings, Rossington departing LBW for 6. Wheater swiftly followed, Overton again, the spearhead of the Somerset counter-attack, seeing the back of the Essex keeper for 4. And it would soon be 7 for the England bowler, Snater caught for 8, the ball not as short as he'd first thought, the visitors down to their last wicket. Simon Harmer is no slouch with the bat and showed that, picking up boundary after boundary as they looked to inflate their lead as much as possible. And he'd carry his bat, Stacchetti the final wicket to fall, trapped in front by Lewis Gregory. Essex all out for 180 at lunch, their lead 71. After slumping to such a low total, Somerset's fight back was impressive. Craig Overton had finished with new career best figures of 7-57 and had given his side a chance to turn the tables. Cook's 59 was a top score for Essex, who'd only managed to add 71 for the loss of 7 wickets. But if Somerset thought the Overton-inspired defiance would continue into their batting, they were sorely mistaken. Two Cooks spoiled the start. First innings top scorer Lamonby caught by the former England captain off the bowling of his namesake. And then Green swiftly followed, pinned in front by Snaiter, the score now 7-2. They were at least into double figures when Hildreth fell for Snaiter's second of the innings. Bales flicked off as the ball kissed the outside of off stump. Renshaw and Abel dragged Somerset past 50, but Essex weren't to be denied. The captain out, caught behind off the bowling of Sacchetti. Was a finish in 2 days in the offing. It certainly looked that way when Snaiter struck again to remove Goldsworthy. A good tumbling grab from Wheater saw him depart for 7. Renshaw looked to be the key man for Somerset, into the 30s before tea, and more importantly for his side, he'd combined with Davis to take a 4-run lead into the break, the score now 75-5. With the innings defeat avoided, Somerset set about the evening session, hoping Renshaw and Davis could stick together. They managed to bring the 100 up, but would be separated. Renshaw out LBW to Sam Cook. Davis was now at the vanguard of a Somerset effort, under pressure, but you wouldn't know it. Harmer lifted casually over the ropes as the keeper moved his way into the 40s, the lead now over 50. For the first time in the match, the hosts looked calm and collected, and Davis took advantage, his 50 sealed, with a single off Sacchetti. The peace was soon broken, though. Gregory out, caught by Sam Cook looking to lift Snaiter over the ropes. Overton lasted just 2 balls, Bales flying around his head, as Snaiter snuck one through to bowl him for 2 and seal a 5-wicket bag. Somerset were down to their last wicket in the next over. Davis, finally removed, bowled by Sacchetti. Leach, now the last man in. And he'd be the final wicket to fall, chopping Snaiter on to depart for 7. Essex were set 84 runs for the win. Once again, the scorecard made difficult reading for Somerset, who were almost certainly heading for defeat. Davis 51 and Renshaw's 45 outliers. Only Abel had joined them in reaching double figures. Snaiter had ripped through them, finishing with figures of 6-36. There'd be time enough for just 2 overs of batting, and a little bit of hope for Somerset. Brown out, caught by Green off the bowling of Overton. Sam Cook came in as night watchman. He and Sir Alistair Cook saw out the remaining 6 balls and reached the close at 3-1. The equation is simple. Essex need a further 81 for what looks to be an almost certain win within 3 days. But Somerset aren't beaten yet. The early wicket was just what the doctor ordered, and in Craig Overton, they have a bowler who could rip through the visitors. Despite an inspired performance with the ball from Craig Overton, who picked up new career best figures of 7-57, Somerset's batting let them down again. The ground clawed back, conceded, and Essex left needing just 81 runs on day 3 for the win. The innings were still in its infancy though. Brown already gone courtesy of Overton, and eyebrows were raised early on the third day. A glimmer of hope, thanks to Overton again. Night watchman Cook out bowled. In the blink of an eye, Essex were 4 down, Siddle with 2 in the next over, Alistair Cook first, caught behind for 3, and then England's Dan Lawrence, out without troubling the scorers. Critchley joined Wesley at the crease, and the pair tried to usher in a sense of calm to proceedings, but Overton was once again determined, and the visitors pegged back, a 10th in the match for the England bowler, when Critchley dragged on to depart for 15. It was remarkable stuff. 3 balls later, Overton had the captain, Wesley caught behind for 6, you couldn't take your eyes off it. Rossington and Wheater took the required runs down to 27 when Overton struck again. A second consecutive fifer sealed for the Somerset man. Wheater trapped in front for 17, just 3 wickets needed now for what had looked an unlikely victory. That was just 2 when Siddle had his third. 4 balls later, Harmer out LBW for a duck. A gorgeous drive down the ground from Rossington left Essex needing fewer than 20. And a rare loose Overton delivery was put away by the on-loan Northamptonshire man, who looked like he decided to accelerate with the finishing line now just 14 runs away. The scores were level when Overton had his 6th of the innings and 13th in the match. Snaiter lifted a catch to Lamonby. Overton had run himself into the ground when Sacchetti scrambled a run from a leg by to seal the win for Essex. The bowler crumpled in a heap. A quite remarkable performance had made this contest so much closer than it ought to have been. He finished the match with impressive figures of 13-87, and with an effort like that, he was unfortunate to be on the losing side. But ultimately, Somerset's batting had crumbled once more, something they'll look to rectify when they return to LV County Championship action away at the Kia Oval against Surrey next time out. Essex, meanwhile, will breathe a sigh of relief, but the tests keep coming. They're off to Edgbaston next week, hoping their match with Warwickshire won't be quite such a nervy affair.